Just when you thought there couldn't be more change going on in the world, it turns out magnetic north is moving. Aviators knew this. It's always moved, but not like this. In fact, it's on the move about 40 miles a year now along the polar cap toward Russia.
This problem is actually so drastic that workers at Tampa International and Peter O'Knight airports are rushing to make changes.
Robert Burr of TIA says runway 36 originally pointed due north to 360 degrees, or it did before the magnetic shift. Now it points just right at 10 degrees north. The last shift was over 700,000 years ago, leaving some to say we're due.
Natural systems that have been stable for millions of years are in turmoil. Plant and animal populations are rapidly declining, and species are becoming extinct faster than ever before. Scientists have begun to call this a mass extinction event.
The last recorded truly mass extinction was about 65 million years ago, presumably because an asteroid hit Earth. The dinosaurs went extinct, and lots of other organisms went extinct, and we're now starting into another mass extinction, except this time it's not an asteroid, it's our own species, Homo sapiens, that's doing the job.
Many of the themes that are promoted on the Fox News channel have to do with generating fear, whether that's fear of immigration, a fear of sexual difference, a fear of racial difference.
Even as Justice Department figures show that violent crime has dropped to a remarkable 30-year low, polls have consistently shown that most Americans believe just the opposite to be true.
I've been through Y2K and I've been through 9/11. I have never seen people so afraid.
The logical question is, why? Well, surveys consistently show that upwards of two-thirds of the people who believe crime to be a very serious personal problem say they get most of their news from television.
It's a special two-hour block.
Four is my last choice, but the risk of doing nothing
is even a worse option as far as I'm concerned.
Dealing with Iraq, the president's war on terror. When will his military plans get put into action?
We hope you depend on us for the truth, because we're going to report the situation in Iraq without an agenda or any ideological prejudice.
The attack came late last night. Police called out to Court Vestergaard's heavily guarded home after a young Somali man armed with an axe and a knife tried to break into his house, threatening to kill him. According to the Danish security services, the 28-year-old Somali has links to Al-Qaeda and the radical Al-Shabaab organization.
Saddam Hussein.
War and danger.
Continuing danger.
Hour of danger.
Very, very dangerous world.
A grave new threat.
Horrific acts of atrocities.
Murderous regimes
dedicating to killing us.
Tyranny and terror.
Slaughtered thousands.
Weapons of mass destruction.
Weapons of mass destruction.
Weapons programs.
The deadliest of weapons.
Terrible weapons.
Nuclear weapons.
Nuclear weapons.
Poison gas.
Torture chambers.
Where this really came into focus was around the events of September 11th, 2001. It was during that time that the United States has two satellites. They're called the GOES, G-O-E-S, Geosynchronous Environmental Satellites, I believe is what they're called. And the role of these satellites is to measure the magnetic fields of the Earth and send back readings every 30 minutes. And those readings normally fall within a certain range of data that scientists are relatively used to seeing. Well, it was in September of 2001 that scientists began to see some readings that were off the map, just off the scale compared to what they'd seen in the past. And they said, well, what's happening? What is it that could be influencing the magnetic fields of the entire planet to such a degree that we're seeing these big spikes that our satellites are sending back? We've never seen these before. They overlaid the data from the satellites onto a calendar of months and days, and lo and behold, what they found is that the spike was occurring precisely during the time of September 11th, 2001, and even more precisely, that the first spike occurred 15 minutes after the first plane hit the first tower in the World Trade Center.